Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Frank, one objection we hear from time to time is when we talk about this idea that, you know, we believe that this universe that we live in was created, then people will say, well, then who created God?
Yeah, that's a great question. It turns out to be a bad question, because if you think about it long enough, if God is uncreated, then he didn't have a beginning. Look, there has to be an uncaused first cause. There's two possibilities. Either the universe is the uncaused first cause, or something that is beyond the universe is the uncaused first cause. And all the evidence shows, both the philosophical and scientific evidence, shows that space, matter, and time had a beginning. In other words, the universe had a cause. It had a beginning, so it must have had a cause, which means whatever's outside the universe must be spaceless, timeless, and immaterial, must be that first cause. Now, if you're timeless, do you have a cause? No, you're eternal. So whatever created the universe is the uncaused first cause. It didn't have a beginning. You know, it amazes me too, Bobby, that a lot of atheists have a lot of trouble believing in an eternal God. Yet for centuries, they believed in an eternal universe, and they had no problem believing in an eternal universe. But somehow, when an eternal God comes up, they go, oh, that can't be. No, the evidence points to the fact that it can be. In fact, there has to be something that's eternal. Even Aristotle knew this. There has to be an unmoved mover.